So recently I purchased on eBay the limited edition box set, the release of A Clockwork Orange. It's from, does I have the date? No, I'm not sure. Some, I guess 2001 or something, around the time it first came out on DVD, I believe. Yeah, I've not seen any unboxing videos for it or anything, so I thought I'd make one and show you what it looks like. So we have the cover with the famous image from the poster, the spine, and on the back it's just a plain see, the 18 stickers are stuck on. I don't know whether they were originally on there or they were put on by the person who I bought from or something. I'm not sure. So we open it up. They actually left the backing, original backing, on here, so we can see, look at that, and look at all the contents. So comes with the DVD. It's the original DVD release, so it only comes with the trailer and interactive menus and scene access. You know, back in the days when they were seen as bonus features. The CD soundtrack, a collectible cenotype, 35mm limited edition film frame, 16-page full-color booklet featuring stories behind the film, the music, plus over 20 photos, and sort of a image of what everything looks like. So we have on this side the CD. This is the main reason I bought this, because I wanted a physical copy of the soundtrack album, and I couldn't find these it on its own for a reasonable price, and I found this quite cheap, so I thought, oh well, I'll get it for the soundtrack album, because I have a Blu-ray copy of the film, so I didn't really buy it for the DVD. I bought it for the album and the nice packaging and stuff. We also have this advert for other limited edition collector's DVD box sets available now. So here's some of the other ones Warner Brothers released. So you have 2001, Full Metal Jacket, Clockwork Orange obviously, The Matrix, Dirty Harry, Blade Runner, Perfect Storm, Blazing Saddles, Bullet, Casablanca, and Gone with the Wind. It's like a postcard you just send off if you want any of these. I don't think they would actually work now though. Next we have the booklet. So same image there. Haven't read through this yet. I think this is quite a clever way to famously, at first, like, none of the Kubrick films had any extras beside the trailer, really, because Stanley Kubrick didn't like extras on his films, so all the Laserdisc releases and the first DVD releases didn't have any. It was until the special edition DVDs and Blu-rays came out that they sort of disregarded his wishes. So I guess this was kind of a clever way of having sort of behind-the-scenes stuff about the film in the, you know, with the DVD without actually putting any on the disc. So it's got some nice photos. That one, gonna have to cover that one, because it's it'll probably get the video flagged. The statue there and Malcolm McDowell, and there's the listings for the soundtrack album. Then we have the film cell. It's, if you can't see it too well, it's basically that on there. It's quite nice. So is that actually from a 35mm print? I guess it is, which is really cool. It's got my number on. So number one. 11,557. So, I'm assuming that's a high number. And last we have the DVD. So, yeah. So it's quite a nice looking set. My only complaint is the hubs on here. It's really difficult to get the discs out. Let's see. They're really straight. Come on, there. It's very, very awkward to get them out of the box. So, wish the hubs were better. But yeah, it's quite a nice set. If you can get it for, you know, if you can find it for a good price, and you know, you like collecting sort of nice editions of films with nice packaging, then I would recommend it. If you just want the film itself, it's just the standard DVD, so if you're not bothered about the other stuff, there's no real point of getting this. You should only get it if you're kind of a packaging collector, or like me, you wanted the soundtrack CD. But yeah, really, really nice set.